Yes.
As we put a cap on corporate profits, just leave, so that just no one corporation like that. Can earn too much money.
Now, I think that's a good idea. What? What do they think will fund free healthcare, free education, and all the other stuff they want to do? Maybe when it comes to money, they don't think. Tax money just flows in magically from corporations that make no profits and rich people. Also, did you know that we all pay taxes voluntarily?
Are people forced to pay taxes? People are required to pay taxes. It's every citizen's responsibility.
Freelance reporter Jan Helfeld likes to confront politicians with their inconsistencies. In this case, Virginia Congressman Gerald Connolly.
If they don't pay their income tax, what will the government do? Will they use force to make them pay or not?
There are penalties for not paying one's obligation.
Okay, so you think that the government isn't forcing the people to pay, right? If they don't pay, will the government use force
I'm not sure where you're going here.
Seems pretty clear to me. If I don't pay my taxes, eventually men with guns will come and put me in jail. I'm not saying there should be no enforcement of our tax system. Our government needs revenue, but why won't congressmen admit that the money is taken by force?
Are people forced to pay taxes?
What do you mean by forced to pay taxes?
Well, California Democrat Xavier Becerra will not accept the force part.
If you don't pay taxes, the government forces you to pay them, right?
How do they force you? If you owe taxes to the American people, and if you didn't pay them, you would pay a fine or...
So people are forced to pay, right?
How are they forced to pay?
If they don't pay, the government will use force to require them to pay.
What force does the government do?
We just went through that.
Yes, he did. Likewise, Democrats love the word redistribution. We're not taking your money and just giving it to our friends. We're doing redistribution to make life fair. Okay, but acknowledge that redistribution is force.
Previously, you had said that the government should protect all peaceful citizens against people that want to use force to take their money, right?
Well, I assume what you meant by that was somebody who was committing a criminal act.
So it's not criminal when politicians do it.
So you think that the government should not protect peaceful citizens against people that want to use force to take their money?
You know, Jan, I think this interview really has no longer served its purpose.
Face facts, politicians. You're in the coercion business. Government is not persuasion or reason. Government is force. Today's Democrats talk peace and love, but what they propose this week in Philadelphia is much more force. That's our show. See you next week.